The dawn of the third age of mankind, 10 years after the Earth-Minbari War. The Babylon Project was a dream given form. Its goal, to prevent another war by creating a place where humans and aliens could work out their differences peacefully. It's a port of call, home away from home, for diplomats, hustlers, entrepreneurs, and wanderers. Humans and aliens wrapped in 2,500,000 tons of spinning metal, all alone in the night. It can be a dangerous place, but it's our last best hope for peace. This is the story of the last of the Babylon stations. The year is 2258. The name of the place is Babylon 5.
I'd like to talk about an episode of Babylon 5, Season 1, called Infection. The episode starts out, there's a gentleman, and he's bringing some equipment onto the station. His name is Nelson, and he's declaring everything that he has. And one of the security guards is asking him, hey, anything hazardous, anything bad? And the security guard notices one of the boxes, and he says, hey, it seems like there's a fake bottom in here. Almost like somebody's trying to bring something in. So Nelson kills him. He electrocutes him or something. Okay. Then we jump to the next scene, I believe. It's a gentleman named Hendrickson. Now, Hendrickson is a mentor and a teacher of Dr. Franklin. So he goes to Dr. Franklin and he tells him about this fantastic new invention. He's found some form of organic technology. And it's very interesting. He explains, he says, listen, we can create technology that would be self-powering. We could create maybe living spaceships. Now, it was a little interesting to me. When he said living spaceships, he said spaceships that can survive, living organic spaceships that can survive out in space. And I didn't get, like, was he saying the Earth Force actually has organic technology that they can create ships, living ships, but those ships cannot survive out in space? Well, they don't have the technology at all. So I was a little confused by that. Okay, but I don't know. Maybe I'll look that up. Maybe that's the point I can find out. Somebody can explain to me. But anyways, he goes on to tell Steven about it, and they talk a little bit about it. They find the body of the security guard that's dead. Of course, they're trying to figure out what happened. Dr. Franklin's studying it, trying to find out if it was foul play or not. Hendrickson comes back and talks to him again. And they have this little ethical debate. And he's saying, look, man, you used to be a researcher. You used to do all this cool stuff. Now he's just going around, going to alien worlds, digging up crap, finding stuff, you know, selling it off to people like some scavenger. And he's telling the doctor, like, look, dude, research takes money. All this stuff takes money. I make more money doing this. Okay. He's like, are you going to help me or not? You know? And he's, you know, basically he says, I found something. And he tells him, look, it's all good. We cleared it through customs at the other place before we got here. Of course, he's lying. Now, anyways, long story short, this episode isn't too deep. Nelson is messing around with the alien technology and somehow it merges. It takes over his mind. Okay. Then he takes on a piece of the technology and attaches it to his body, and he starts turning into, like, I don't know, like Megatron or something. He's got a cannon on his arm. He starts turning into Megatron, and he goes around blasting people, and with his Sith lightning. I mean, yeah, it's electricity. Like, he's shooting force lightning at people, which actually was pretty cool. You don't know at this point why he's blasting people. He actually kills this man and a woman. And he vaporizes him. And it's like they're nothing but just like a chalk, dirt on a, just like a stain on the wall, okay? So he's blasting people. He's busting Sith lightning electrical caps in people's butts, okay? Of course, the station, they found out about this because these electrical outbursts he's shooting, they're showing up on their equipment. So they go and they find out, and they find this crazy dude, and they start fighting him, and they're shooting at him, and it's not having any effect on him at all. You know, it's just bouncing off of him. Now, this dude was kind of cool when he was turning into this alien creature, because not only does he have armor that their weapons have no effect on, he can blow holes in the bulkhead, he can blow holes in the walls and the floors, and this dude just disappears, you know. So basically, they kind of figure out that, hey, you know what, it's kind of funny. We got this guy, this alien being, and he's going around killing people around the same time as this security guard came over here. So they start talking to Dr. Franklin. He's like, yeah, you know, Harrington did bring on some organic technology, and I guess they put two and two together, and they figure out, hey, you brought something on this station, which happens a lot on Babylon 5. Also, what happens a lot on Babylon 5 is you got people going around alien worlds digging up old technology, and it's dangerous. But you know what? It makes a lot of sense to me that that would happen. But anyways, they kind of figure out, Hendrickson and Franklin go back and they study more of this technology, and they figured out that basically some of this technology that was like alien weapon technology, but it's intelligent. Okay. This particular race, the Arkarans, they have been conquered multiple times over the years. So they created this technology that would constantly keep improving and was so powerful that it could defeat anybody. But unfortunately, it turned on them and killed them as well. Because when they programmed it, this technology was programmed to fight anybody who was not pure Arkarans. So I guess the programming of this technology was very strict, okay, to the point where even any slight deviation, it would kill you. So it started killing them as well, okay. And this particular unit, I guess it was a bunch of these different alien units, these different technologies that could attach to organic beings. And this particular one is the one that the Dr. Henderson dug up, okay. And they found out that basically, I guess, artificial intelligence takes a long time to develop, according to them. So basically what they did was took like the mentality, the minds of living beings, and somehow copied that to these machines. So they're able to find out what particular alien being mindset was attached to this particular piece of alien equipment. And they're able to talk to him and kind of reason with him and tell him, hey, you know, dude, y'all screwed up. You guys messed up. You did it wrong, buddy. So eventually, the alien realizes that they screwed up, okay? They messed up and they end up killing their own people. So he commits suicide. Now, that's not before he runs around, leading security on a merry chase, killing people, blasting holes in the station. Because before they get him to their realization, he's still confused at first. He thinks he's protecting the planet. So he believes that station is the planet. And these people, you know, on the station, these staff and the people walking around are invaders. So he's running around killing them. And the commander takes a dangerous choice. And he comes up with the idea that, hey, we can't stop this dude. Let's get him to the airlock and let's blow him out the airlock. Now, ultimately, that doesn't happen. Like I said, he's able to do a reason with the alien. The actual human intelligence that's connected to this alien's device that has attached itself to Nelson's body and merged with him and let it know that, hey, you guys screwed up. Your planet is dead. Your people are gone. This is, you know, pointless. And the thing sort of just pulls itself out of Nelson's body and sort of, I guess, commits suicide in a sense. I don't know if artificial intelligence can do that. Anyway, it goes, Nelson, I guess, survives, and they realized that Nelson actually killed the security guard. You know, of course, and Dr. Franklin tricks Hendrickson into telling off on himself and admitting that he did know that Nelson didn't bring the stuff in through properly through customs, and that he didn't care, And Leah's just like, screw it, man. You know, let's keep this on the hush and hush. We can make money. We can go sell this weapon technology to different corporations. And Henderson gets arrested. Okay. All in all, you know, a pretty good episode, man. It's not an episode that I watch a lot because it's really not a lot to this episode. It's just basically some nice action. You got a cool looking alien. I mean, dude looks like I said, he looks like a evil Megatron, a more evil version of Megatron. And I actually wish that they could have brought this technology back or used it or actually have blown Nelson merged with this machine out into space and let him come back in another episode or something like that. I don't know. I feel like they could have did a follow-up episode to this. Okay. But either way it goes, pretty decent episode. It's not really storyline-wise. It's not really one of the deepest storylines. It honestly feels like a filler storyline. I'm going to be honest with you. It's an episode that I don't hate, but I don't really watch it all that much. There really is not a lot to the episode. You don't have like Londo, DeLynn. They're not the Jakar. They're not in this episode. Okay. This episode really doesn't advance the storyline. Most of the time in Babylon 5, there are things in the episode, even if it's just small, that you'll see later on. It's building to something. I really don't see anything that this episode was building to. There's really nothing memorable in this episode. I mean, besides some nice action scenes. And, you know, you see the commander get blasted with the lightning, which was funny to me because a blast from this lightning was killing other people, but somehow it just knocks him back. Now, I know at the time he wears body armor, so I'm guessing that's in it. That body armor absorbed it or something. And, you know, it's kind of cool that with this alien, that he's getting more and more powerful. They said the longer he lives, the more powerful he gets. So, effectively, if they didn't stop him in time, he'd be more powerful. He'd be strong enough to blow up the entire station. Because usually a lot of times when you hear about these storylines, oh, an alien race created this technology, and this technology turned on them. It's like, I don't really see that. But with this technology, this technology that can take over a person's body and steadily increase its power to the point where it can blow up entire stations, you actually can see that. Because this dude would actually be the ultimate stormtrooper. The ultimate soldier. Weapons can't hurt him. They even mentioned that some weapons they have that are might be powerful enough to stop this dude would blow up the whole station. Okay. So you have to ask this question. How powerful would this dude have gotten? How powerful would he have gotten? Would he have continued to get stronger and stronger? Well, I could see them destroying a whole planet if they're this powerful. Okay. At the end of the episode, there's a scene where basically Garibaldi's telling the commander, hey, dude, you're taking too many chances. You know, you ran out there. You had this alien thing following you. You're taking too many risks. And it's like, hey, you know, I know some of you guys who've been in a war and in the military, you guys missed that thrill. And some of you guys take unnecessary risks, man. You need to really, as your friend and your officer, you need to chill out with these unnecessary risks, man. You know, I would love to actually see one of these science fiction shows where a commanding officer, the captain or commander, goes and takes unnecessary risk, and you actually have an admiral or a general or somebody over them tell them, hey, look, dude, you know, we're gonna write you up. You got a staff. That's what your security guys is for. That's what this person is for. You need to let them handle that, or you need to stay on the ship. You're the most experienced officer, so we need you running everything, not going out there taking all these risks. I would love to see that. Of course, that'll probably never happen. But, you know, man, like I said, not a bad episode. Overall, interesting enough storyline. Kind of thin storyline. Not a lot of character development going on. Really, there's nothing set up in this episode that carries on to another episode. There really is not a lot to even talk about in this episode. Just a cool looking alien, which they don't do anything with because he never shows up again. And to the best of my knowledge, unless I'm wrong, they don't do anything else with this specific technology. I might be wrong about that, but I don't remember this technology ever popping up. So like I said, dude, it's not a bad episode. just not one that you really would need to watch all the time because it's kind of a filler episode. But you could do worse. One good thing about Babylon 5, honestly, I don't think I've watched what I would call a bad episode. I've watched bad episodes of a lot of other science fiction shows, but there's no episode of Babylon 5 that I honestly say I could hate. So, you know, check it out, man. Worth a watch. One thing I would have liked to see them do that they didn't do, if he's talking about Garibaldi sending the commanders taking all these risks and stuff, I would like to have seen that. I would like to have seen him take a lot more risks. I mean, he may have took some more risks as the season went on, but I would like to have seen him do something where he took a risk, took a danger that he didn't have to. He didn't, like, seriously injured him to the point where he almost was going to die or something like that. I would like to have seen it. Like, when he's talking about, hey, you know, you were in a war, now you need this adrenaline rush, you need this thrill. I would like to have seen him to go off the rails with that. Like, just really go berserk to it to the point where they have to pull him aside and say, hey, dude, you got to calm down or we're going to have to demote you or something like that. But, you know, they never did that. But like I said, man, not a bad episode. Worth a watch. As filler goes, it's not bad filler.